But
when you're saying fructose, what about fructose found in fruits, or is that as much of a problem?
Well, fructose is of course a fruit sugar. That's how it gets its name. And but when it's again in the context of a food, like a let's say even an orange or an apple, you are not getting either the dose of fructose or the packaging of fructose that you get when you add sugar to a Coke,
right?
And you're drinking it in a concentrated form. It's absorbed more rapidly, and there's much more of it. You have to eat an awful lot of fruit to get the amount of fructose that you get from a single can of Coke, for example. But also importantly, it's the fiber and it's the overall packaging of the sugar that can sort of buffer its metabolic effects in fruits that I think make it much less of a problem from a dietary standpoint.
So just
standpoint.
Let people understand, you know, it's your research and others have shown that it's more of the foods that have a high glycemic index, maybe foods that are more refined, have added sugars, added fructose.
Well, I've been trying to carefully avoid that issue because I think there's still a lot of uncertainty on that score. I think that the effects of fructose, the metabolic effects of fructose, are unquestionable. I don't think there's any doubt that this fructose makes fat, makes the liver, when it encounters fructose, makes fat, and that starts this whole process in motion. Starches, again, coming in various packages, ranging from more easily processed and more rapidly broken down starches that make glucose, because that's the breakdown product of the starch. They're considered high glycemic index, ranging in starches that are less processed and consumed in the context of high fiber, which are less rapidly broken down, have lower glycemic index. That's all, no question about the differences in those characteristics of those starches. However, it's been difficult to show that glycemic index itself is an important influence on lipoprotein metabolism, or for that matter, on heart disease risk. We sort of vilify processed foods, which I think there's a good reason to do, and that spills over into vilifying processed starches. And I don't have any reason to recommend. You know, I see patients. I certainly tell them to stay away from that stuff because it just adds calories and doesn't have all the nutrients that are contained in a fiber-rich whole grain form. But whether the glycemic index itself or the glycemic load, which is the total amount of those carbohydrates that are consumed that raise blood sugar levels, whether those are really harmful or not, I've tried to stay out of that argument because I don't think there's really been a compelling amount of evidence either way. In fact, the study was just reported by a colleague of mine from Harvard in which they failed to show a relationship between glycemic index and LDL levels, you know, or lipid levels. So I'd say that's an open question. I think focusing on sugars and added sugars is a way that we can all come together. People that have been focused on fat as a culprit, for the most part, are also acknowledging that added sugars is a big problem. So we've come together on this issue. Beyond that, I think we still have a lot to learn.